I'm going to go through this. Is it difficult to identify the difficult airway? I'm going to say that I don't think so. I think if someone looks a bit not quite right, a bit NQR, the airway is probably a bit NQR, just that like that last case. So imagine these patients here. You know, this patient is, you know, has morbid obesity, makes it very difficult. This patient has a really poor malum patty and also obesity. This one has the fixed neck. This patient has a rough, you know, beard. So you know that one aspect is going to be difficult. A trauma patient is going to be difficult for all the other reasons of trauma as well. And this child here with Pierre-Robin syndrome is always going to be difficult as well due to that congenital problem. So the lining up of these axes are always going to be difficult in these patients. And it's very obvious to you because it just looks like that at the end of the bed. So the reason we have all these fancy tests in science is that, you know, science is about finding answers. Eponymous names are great for authors. And occasionally you may have an unpredicted difficult airway, but critically examining an airway may help you predict this. The thing is though, most of these events are very rare. As you saw with the data, CICO and difficulties in this are quite rare. So if an event is rare, statistically the positive predictive value of a test or the real world application of a test is always very low. So here's the data on this. And I just want you to look at that positive predictive value. So if I think something, if one of my tests is positive, the chance of me being right is really low, 25%, 38%, 21%. This is terrible. You would not bet on this, right? In fact, the history of difficult intubation is the highest predictor. So, you know, that's probably your best test, getting a previous anesthetic chart or previous anesthetic letter. So why do we do this if they're all so bad? It's because we want to get a system that we can use to manage things in a logical way, even though we know that they might not be exactly right. So I think, in summary, the very difficult airway is easy to identify. They look not quite right. The unexpected difficult airway will often be a surprise. So what's far more important is optimizing each technique, moving on to the next plan without fixation, and not persisting at a failing technique, because that will traumatize the airway. So in this next phase, what we're going to go through is, again, I want you guys to know how to optimize things in a very consultant-like fashion, but it's actually not too hard to learn. It's really just targeting to optimize each expected difficulty as you see it. Caution, adding any level of complexity to an easy airway can make it very difficult. Low sats due to lung disease, severe cardiovascular compromise, foreign environment, unfamiliar equipment, junior assistant, that all equals a difficult airway. So, you know, just be mindful that the context is everything.